Okay, Michael, so I think with that little bit of discussion, I feel like we're done.
Cool. All right. Well, it's been nice talking to you. I hope the course went well. And oh, you mean just for this lesson?
Yeah, just for this lesson.
All right. Well,
So
let's wrap up this lesson then.
let's see, what have we learned? So remind me, Michael, what have we learned?
Well, we were talking about instance-based learning.
That's true. That's the first thing we learned. You'll notice, by the way, I never actually told you why it was called instance-based learning.
Charles, why is it called instance-based learning?
I don't know, but I'm willing to guess that it has to do with the fact that we look at the exact instances that we have and we base our learning on that.
All right, and we brought it up in by starting off thinking about eager and lazy learning.
Right. What is the difference, Michael?
I will tell you when I need to tell you.
That's exactly right.
So lazy learning is about putting off the work until it's actually needed. Eager is about as soon as the problem is posed, solve it, and then, you know, if you're lucky, then the answer will eventually come in handy.
Exactly right. Okay, what else?
So as a concrete example of a lazy learner, we talked about K nearest neighbors or KNN.
KNN. Yeah, and this whole notion of nearest neighbor is, in fact, one way of talking about similarity functions.
Right, and the similarity functions play a really central role in all of this.
Right. Similarity. We talked about it as if they were distance functions, but distance is just another way of talking about a similarity. So this is actually a key thing. KNN was a specific algorithm we used, and we talked about various versions of it. And the nearest neighbor part really got us to think a little bit about similarity and distance and what all that means. A really important thing here is, I think, that similarity is just another way of capturing domain knowledge. And K and KNN is another way of capturing domain knowledge. And that if we saw through the quizzes and through some of our discussion that this is actually very, very important, that domain knowledge matters.
Now, we also talked about KNN in the context of both regression and classification. Ah, I see what you did there. Knowledge. It's got KNN in it.
Okay, so yeah, so classification and regression are different things, but KNN can handle both of them. And at the end of the day, that's all stuck in our notion of similarity and our notion of averaging, which we kind of took as an overall term for a bunch of different things you might do, which some people might find confusing, but I think that other people would really kind of understand what we mean.
I'm very tempted to take that out of Wikipedia, but that would just be rude.
It would be rude. Anything else? We learned one big thing.
We looked at how to compose various different learning algorithms together. For example, in the context of locally weighted linear regression, we used this instance-based idea along with linear regression to get something that was both sort of locally smooth but globally bumpy.
Right. So I'm going to just say locally weighted regression, where we can do any kind of regression we might want to. And I'm just going to call that dollar sign X. So stick in your favorite value.
Let's see, what else? Oh, a really big thing was Bellman's curse of dimensionality.
Yes.
And the idea there was that the more features that you include, the more data that you need to fill up that space.
Yep. It's exponential.
And in fact, I decided to go and play with this a little bit. So that example that you were doing before, where the y equals x1 squared plus x2, when I gave it, well, as we saw in the example, we gave it like 10 or 12 examples and it did really badly.
Yeah.
So it continued to do somewhat badly until I got to about 100,000. And then it was actually doing really well. But that seems like an awful lot of examples for what is otherwise a very simple problem.
Right. Well, if you think about it, the amount of data you have to see to determine the relative relevance of the two different dimensions is quite a bit in that particular kind of function. Yeah, and that's a lot of space to cover all possible real values across a potentially infinite space.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Yeah. So the curse of dimensionality is real, and we just sort of can't get around it. Although, as I mentioned earlier, we will see in the second part of the course ways that people try to get around the curse of dimensionality.
Aha.
Okay.
Or at least
Well,
blunt it, right?
yeah, or at least because you can't actually get around the curse of dimensionality. You can only deal with it.
There is no free lunch.
There is no free lunch. In fact, that's a theorem. Isn't that a theorem?
Yeah, I think so.
What's the theorem?
No free lunch. that any learning algorithm that you create is going to have the property that if you average over all possible instances, it's not doing any different than random.
Right. And another way of thinking about that, a practical way of thinking about that is, if I don't know anything about the data that I'm going to have to learn over, then it doesn't really matter what I do because there's all possible kind of data sets. However, if I have domain knowledge, I can use that to choose the best learning algorithm for the problems that I'm going to encounter.
So does that mean that all of machine learning really comes down to you have to already know what you need to solve the problem to apply these techniques to solve the problem?
No, but you have to know a little bit about your problem in order to decide what to do. And in fact, you can make the argument that this entire class is about exposing the students to a wide range of techniques and giving them enough practice so that they can do a pretty good job of telling, given a problem, would it be better to use this kind of technique or this kind of technique? Is KNN a sort of better way of approaching it? Decision trees a better way of approaching it? This is a lot of what this class is about, is helping them to get enough domain knowledge, or enough knowledge anyway, so that they can apply it to particular domains.
Cool. All right. Well, that seems like a plenty useful lesson.
Yes, it's a very hopeful note to end on. So let's end on that.
All right. See you next time.
All right. Bye, Michael.